Hi, I'm Joey, and I'm going to tell you about Cerberus, a new solver that I've been developing with Ross Anderson, Bochon Liu, and Tu Nguyen. So Cerberus is a new solver for a class of hard, non-convex optimization problems that's really made possible by the Jump ecosystem. So we introduce new modeling primitives into Jump to capture the structures that we want. And then we take advantage of the performant modeling and the exposure of advanced functionality that MathOp interface allows. So just to make sure everyone's on the same page, I'll briefly describe what mixed integer programming or MIP is. So this is a class of optimization problems with linear objectives, linear constraints, and integrality constraints on some or all of your decision variables. So typically MIPs are solved using a branch and bound algorithm. So you build a search tree, and you solve a series of closely related linear programming problems, or LPs, at each node in that search tree. The performance of a branch and bound algorithm is strongly dependent on a number of factors. One important one is what's called the strength of the formulation, essentially how tightly that formulation captures the feasible region. Additionally, since we're solving so many LPs, being able to efficiently solve them, or rather resolve them, because they're so closely related, is very important for reducing computational time. Our second class of optimization problems are what are called disjunctive programming problems. So these look very familiar from the previous slide, except we now have what are called disjunctive constraints that constrain our decision variables to lie in a finite union of sets. So you can view this as a generalization of MIP if you'd like, but really it's a way of naturally modeling complex logical constraints into your optimization problem. So this is a really natural modeling paradigm for things like scheduling, process engineering, or for modeling piecewise linear functions. You typically solve disjunctive programming problems by converting them to a MIP. So there's generic techniques you can use, or you can try to take advantage of particular problem structure that you might have. Generally speaking, how this will work is you start with your disjunctive programming problem. You look at each of those disjunctive constraints, and you build a mixed integer programming formulation for it. So you use the primitives that MIP allows, you add new variables and constraints, and then you take that whole MIP formulation, you throw it to your favorite solver, and you call it a day. I would call this the flattened model. So I want to point out two things. The first is that this formulation is static. You write it once before you call the solver, and then you don't change it. Additionally, you're not explicitly passing the disjunctive constraint information. Instead, it's implicitly modeled through whatever mixed integer programming formulation you decided to use. So what could go wrong here? I want to show you an example with a simple three-piecewise linear function. So at the root node, I might build a strong formulation, so it captures the convex hull of the feasible region. However, once I start branching, the number of pieces which are feasible reduces. So now at this node, I might only have the first and the second piece which are feasible, and the third is no longer under consideration. So if I were to build a strong formulation for just the first and the second piece, I would get something that looks like this. However, based on how I originally formulated things in my static formulation, I might instead get a formulation that gives me this. So you can see there's a gap here, there's a difference between the two, and this will generally lead to worse dual bounds, which in turn will lead to more enumeration in my search tree and slower computational times. So one disadvantage of a static formulation is that as you go deeper in the search tree, your formulation might get worse and worse. This might lead you to believe that an alternative is to dynamically formulate at each node in the search tree. This is conceptually possible, but there's a couple barriers. The first is just that it's more complicated. Second, it's not clear how the solver could actually do this if it only receives the flattened model without the explicit disjunctive constraints. Third, you'll typically spend more time rebuilding the models if you have to do it at each node. And you potentially have to spend a lot more time resolving those LPs if you don't take advantage of warm starting capabilities in your LP solver. So this is where Cerberus comes in. Cerberus is a solver for mixed integer programming problems with disjunctive constraints. So think of blending those two classes of optimization problems we saw at the beginning. It's built entirely in Julia, and it uses Gurobi to solve all the LPs. It treats disjunctions as first-class modeling primitives, It dynamically updates the formulations inside of the search tree, and it tries to do that in a way that will preserve the warm starting capabilities of Gurobi. So essentially, you can think of Cerberus as owning the model and the search tree, and then farming out to Gurobi all the LP solves at each of the nodes. So a Cerberus model essentially is a mixed integer programming model with additional information that tracks the disjunctive constraints. We call these disjunctive formulators. So they take an arbitrary node in the search tree. They will compute the alternatives of each of the disjunctive constraints which are feasible for that node, and then they will build a formulation for just those feasible alternatives. So by default, Cerberus uses a simple Big M formulation, and in fact, on dives, as it goes deeper into the search tree, it will just reuse the same model in memory with a static formulation. However, when it backtracks, it will rebuild the model, it will tighten it for the current node, and additionally, it will seed the parent node's optimal basis to try to take advantage of warm starting. I'm not going to go into more details on the formulations, the warm starting scheme, or the implementation. Instead, I want to show you a little bit of code. So this is a jump model for a simple scheduling problem that uses Cerberus as the underlying solver. So this should seem pretty familiar if you used jump before. The new stuff is here in gray. So essentially, we're adding disjunctive constraints using the function in set schema available in jump and MathOp interface. So here, the function is a vector of affine expressions, and the set is a hypercube that describes for each of those affine expressions what are the upper and lower bounds for each of the alternatives. So this allows you to model really complicated disjunctive constraints where maybe those affine expressions are replicated across multiple alternatives. Maybe you have lower and upper bounds on particular expressions and things of that nature. So Cerberus is a prototype. Right now we're working through a benchmarking phase. We're essentially trying to track the performance gains that you get for doing this dynamic reformulation and for doing this warm starting scheme. Additionally, we're also going to be looking at the wall time. Once this benchmarking is out of the way, there's a bunch of things that we want to add on top. We want to be able to reformulate inside the tree without doing a complete rebuild, so to take advantage of the problem modification that's available in MathOp interface. We want to be able to run propagators at each node to compute tighter bounds and then compute tighter formulations. We want to explore alternative formulations and different tightening schemes. Potentially, we want to be able to drop unnecessary variables as we go deeper into the search tree. And we want to turn on the pre-solve routines available in MathOp pre-solve. So thank you so much for your attention. I'll be willing to take any questions that you might have.